treatment-resistant major depressive disorder. Caused trauma in my wife, my family, all of us. But the only person worse for than it is for the person suffering is for their partner. You know, I felt worse for my wife than I did for me.
My name is Barbara Nelson. I'm 45 years old. I'm the mother of three children, and I'm married to John Nelson. The John I remember from 22 years ago. He was like so outgoing and friendly, and he had like such an enthusiasm for doing everything and anything. So when we were in our, you know, 20s, early 30s, I remember him having periods of depression, but it was never like anything too dramatic. I would say early on, it was more like, is it me? Does he not like me anymore? But then after our third child was born, it was probably when it started to get bigger. You know, staying in bed for a really long period of time, super irritable. And there would definitely be periods where you're like, I can't take it anymore. Can't you just get up? Even though I knew that he was suffering, I almost felt like I was alone, doing everything and then trying to make things a little better. I know a lot more now than I did 10 years ago. So at that time, some of my coping strategies were just go, 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 go. And that didn't work. You know, over the years, just the understanding of his illness made me like motivated to support him. No matter how horrible he felt, he really still loved me and still loved the kids. So that's, I think, like what saved our family. At the time that we heard about deep brain stimulation, he had been through quite a few treatments already. And I was very apprehensive about having brain surgery. What if he dies on the operating room table? What if it doesn't work? But not doing it was also risky. After the surgery, he just started to feel better so quickly. His energy level is back. And we always joke, we're like, can we turn it down a little? Like, is there like a setting that we can like dial it back? And he keeps evolving. The longer he feels good and is able to maintain that, the more I feel like maybe this is gonna be our new normal. I've been in like such survival mode for so long that I'm just starting to process or unpack it all. But I think part of John's success was my support. Because if I had been belittling it or not taking it seriously, I don't think he would have had the resources to be able to follow through on everything. The kids are also proud of their dad. They see it like any other illness, that if they had a parent who had, you know, diabetes or cancer or something else, that it would probably feel similar. We're becoming a new family again. That just feels really good.